Bonjour, bonjour, and welcome to lesson 9. We are nearly at the end of module 1. So today we're going to be learning all numbers, asking questions, and getting ready for conversation, because our last lesson will be the end of module 1. That will be next lesson. Okay, so before I move on, very quickly, can I remind you of the French Ignition website? Contact us there if you want to give us anything, hand in any work, recordings, anything. I'm more than happy to have a look at it. And also, one of the main things we do at French Ignition is French conversation groups. There are groups for beginners, so contact us, and if there isn't one in your area, we can easily set up one if there's enough people asking for it. So let's get started. Numbers, and remember last time we stopped at 60. So we're just going to keep going as we usually do. 61, 60 and 1. 61, 62, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. But where normally we would change and get onto a different number, listen to what happens next. 70. We're not stopping here. We get to 70. So when we get to 70, we're actually saying 60, 10, 70. After 10 comes 11. So if we want to move into the 70s, that would be 71, 71, 71. After 11 is 12. 72, 72, 72. 12 to 13. 73, 73, 73. 13 to 14. 74, 74, 74. 14 to 15. 75, 75, 75. Then 15 to 16. 76, 76, 76. 16 to 17. 77, 77, 77. And to 18, 78, 78, 78. And on to 19, 79, 79, 79. And now we can change onto a new number, 80, which is 80, 80, 80, 80. Now we're going to start from scratch again. So we've got 80, 80, 81, 81, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85. 86, 87, 88, 89. Remember, we keep going. 90, 80, 10. So 90 is nothing but 80 and 10. 90, after 10 is 11. 91, watch out for that one. We don't have the we, a, and in between. So 91. 91, 91. After 11 is 12. 92, 92, 92. 93, 93, 93. 94, 94, 94, 95, 95, 95, 96, 96, 96, 97, 97, 97, 98, 98, 98, 99, 99, 99, and now we can change 100, 100, 100. You don't need to say 1 in front of it. 100 is 100, well, 100. So 200 would be 200, 300 would be 300, 400, 500, etc. And 1000, 1000, which is 1000. So 1000 on its own would be 1000. 2000, 2000, 3000, 3000, 4000, 5000, etc. So let's see what happens here. When we went from 10 to 50, if you look at 10 to 50 as the on the fingers of one hand on the left hand side. So let's imagine that each finger was representing 10, then 20, then 30, then 40 and 50. In between each of them, you will notice that there's 9 numbers in between. So to go from 10 to 20, before I reach 20, I would add 9. From 20 to 30, also 9. So 20, 20, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and then I would move to 30. Same thing here, at 9, 39, once I get to 39, 39, I would change number again to 40, and then the same to 50. But when I look at the fingers of the other hands, I don't need numbers for between 60 and 80, or between 80 and 100. And the reason for that is because we, instead of just changing number after 9, we change number after 19. So if you have 60, we would have 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, and 71, we keep going, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, and now we change to 80, which is here, 80. Okay, then we keep going, 81, 82, 83, we get to 10, 90, so that would be our 90 in here, but it's 80, 10. 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, and now we reach 100. So our 90 would be in here, but 90 is nothing more than 80, 10. And 70 in here, should be in here, is nothing more than 60, 10. Okay. So let's move on, and the thing is that you quite often will find it difficult when listening to numbers, knowing which one is 60, which one is 70. So what to do when you hear 60 as a number, you hear obviously 60, think to yourself, okay, I know that 60 is 60. Now it all hinges on what comes after that. Anything after 60 that comes between 1 and 9 will keep it in the 60s. 61, 62, 65, 67, 69, anything like that will be in the 60s. But if you hear anything after 60, which is between 10 and 19, that will move it onto the 70s. 71, 75, 77, that moves it to the 70s. Same thing for 80. If you hear 80, think to yourself, okay, 80, I know it's 80. What comes after it? Anything between 1 and 9 will keep it in the 80s. But anything between 10 and 19 will move it into the 90s. Okay, so saying the year, because you're going to apply number to when you say the year. Voici la Révolution française, the French Revolution. If I'm asking you, when did it take place? C'était quand la Révolution française? You're going to tell me the date in here. So you're going to use en for in, the same en we used in front of feminine countries to say in, en. And then the date reads like a number. So we don't say like you do in English 1789 as two different set of numbers. We say it as 1789, just like a normal number. So 1000 is 1000. 700, 700. And then that leaves us with 89, 89. La Révolution française, c'est en 1789. Okay, have a go at some of the dates that come next. So, à vous. And you've got to tell me when these events take place. And you have to work out how to say these dates in French. La bataille de Waterloo, c'était quand? En 1815. La découverte de l'Amérique, c'était quand? En 1492. La première presse inventée, c'était quand? En 1440. L'Internet a été inventé quand? En 1983. L'élection de Donald Trump. En 2017. La victoire de la Coupe du Monde par la France. En 2018. Now, asking questions is dead simple. Let's have a look at it. And it's going to be fun and it's going to be easy. So, asking question, very, very simple. You start with a statement. For example, vous êtes anglaise. Now, you've done enough French just now to work out that means you are English. If I pose my voice at the end, vous êtes anglaise. I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. You are English. I know that. You are English indeed. Vous êtes anglaise. If I want to turn that into a question, then that's very easy. All I have to do is raise my voice on the last syllable. And that gives you, vous êtes anglaise? Vous êtes anglaise? So same sentence, but just raising your voice on the last syllable gives you a question. Let's have a look at more. Vous parlez français? You are indeed speaking French. Vous parlez français. I know that. Vous parlez français? Do you speak English? Vous parlez français? Vous habitez en Espagne? A statement. If I drop my voice, it's a statement. Vous habitez en Espagne? Vous habitez en Espagne? Do you live in Spain? Vous habitez en Espagne? Vous travaillez avec les enfants? Statement. Vous travaillez avec les enfants? Vous travaillez avec les enfants? So simply raise your voice on the last syllable and you've got yourself a question. Okay, c'est tout pour aujourd'hui et pour la prochaine fois, we're going to do a bit of revision. And we're going to have a full first conversation, or you're going to have a first conversation. Now, remember to check the French Ignition website for a detail of our conversation groups. There are groups for beginners as well. And also, if you want to contact me via the website, I'd be more than happy to look at anything you want to submit to me, or if you want to ask any question, please contact us at www.frenchignition.co.uk. Ok, c'est tout pour aujourd'hui. Au revoir.